Hello, Seattle. Okay, I know a lot of you aren't interested in the disaster preparedness side, so you came for the homicide part. And I'm going to give you a tip. It works only on men, so man on man works. Woman on woman won't work. So disasters happen. Look at this list. This is a short list. Interesting on this, five of those disasters are not forecasted. You can't forecast an earthquake. You're come-as-you-are disasters. So the problem is most people are not prepared for disasters, even though when you poll them, 40% of people say they are prepared for disasters. And I think that is horsepucky. 40% of emergency managers are not prepared for disasters. So being prepared is a choice. No one's going to make you become prepared. You have to choose, and if you choose not to, there are consequences. So, four stages of denial, a disaster will not happen. What in the last few days? Chile, California wildfires, the flood in Nevada. Disasters do seem to happen, folks. They do happen. If a disaster happens, it will not happen to me. Watch the news. There's some old codger standing up there. I just saw it the other day. I lived here all my life, and I've never seen it right like this. But it's true. Okay, if it does happen to me, it won't be that bad. This is the Nisqually earthquake. The ground shook. We evacuated the city. We went home, picked up the kids, and watched TV at night. In auto terms, that was a fender bender earthquake. It was not the big one. And then if it does happen, it is that bad, there's nothing we can do about it. That's stinking thinking. Only 2% of people die in a catastrophic disaster. You will be alive. So what you do before is important. So make a plan. Remember the second slide? You got to write the plan down. It won't take very long. Maybe 30 minutes. How are you going to communicate? What is it that you need? And that will direct what goes in your kit. You need water. In 72 hours, you don't have water, you'll start dying. That's a fact. It all has to be in one place. And how long do you want to be prepared for? Basic, 3 days. Not enough. 1 week, better. Get training. No one is coming in a disaster. Fire. They aren't. Fire and police are not coming. So, look at Red Cross training, CERT, what have you. Now, the premise for the homicide, this fits. Trust me, it works every day. So women, you can do this. Absolutely. No problem whatsoever. So what you have to do is get something that is a surefire killer. This is the gift that keeps on killing. So you say, I live in an apartment. That's the best thing yet. Give it to him. He won't be able to resist starting it up in the living room, so you don't want to be around, you know. So a stocking stuffer, you need some gasoline, you know. So don't give him the fire extinguisher. I mean, he won't know how to use that anyway, and he won't read the directions. An alternative to the gas generator is the chainsaw. I do not recommend this. Cut off his foot, cut off his arm, blind himself. Then the guy that annoys you is just now an invalid, and you got to take care of him. So, okay, switching gears here. Studies show people have to hear a disaster preparedness presentation. This is one. 20 times before they do anything. If you don't do something within the first 24 hours, you're not going to do anything. So what does that mean? You have to do something. Your action plan. Remember that second slide? Make a effing plan, which means you have to write it down. You got to build a kit for home, the car, and at work. Being prepared is like fastening your seatbelt. I've driven, it'll be next month, 50 years, and I've never had an accident. I'm not going to fasten my seatbelt anymore because evidently I don't need to. So it's a risk perception problem. You are, like three-year-olds. Walking along the cliff, 300-foot drop, and you perceive no risk. We are at risk. So here's my blog. If you're interested in disaster preparedness, you can Google disaster preparedness. And there's two people here from Seattle Office of Emergency Management information on Seattle Alert. Where are you, Debbie and Matt? Yay! See them. There you go. Thank you very much.